Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. In the previous update, I mentioned the tight convergence of planetary conjunctions, and so far that has not resulted in a major seismic event. If you look at the SHI graph magnitude 5.6 and larger, we see most of the clustering actually occurred early on the 10th with the planetary conjunctions and additional larger seismic activity west of Macquarie Island region 6.3. and also at the Fox Islands, Aleutian Islands 5.6 at the time of the very tight convergence. And then we see some stronger seismic events actually spread out over the week. Also following the new moon, another 6.3 in Western Afghanistan. And Western Afghanistan really had some really strong earthquakes there. And if you are in that region, beware of damaged buildings, because with an aftershock, and aftershocks are likely to continue in the coming days, maybe even weeks, quite some changes in stress distribution there. And it makes things pretty unpredictable. Stay away from damaged buildings. That's very important. And other than that, please consult your local authorities for the best course of action and what to do. So very bad, actually, the situation in Afghanistan. Okay, and also, what you do not see here on the SGI graph is additional strong tremors, 6.4 that occurred actually this morning at the Aleutian Islands at the time of the high lunar peak. And as you can see here today, also on the 17th, this is the next planetary conjunction. And we go into the next time frame on the SHI graph for the coming week. And we see this planetary conjunction, which is actually Venus, Mercury and Mars. And that occurred this morning. And we know that with planetary conjunctions involving Mercury in particular, we can have, or usually have, an increase in seismic activity. The typical clustering of stronger earthquakes, magnitude 5.6 and larger. And we see three peaks, actually four peaks, but we see three peaks also involving Venus. These are the purple peaks. There's red in there as well, which means it's a convergence. No, it's not a convergence, it's a combination of Mercury and Venus in a single conjunction. And like I said, we had them this morning, and we also have the next one tomorrow, that is a Mercury, Venus, Uranus. And then on the 20th, we have a convergence. One is with Mercury, that's Mercury, Sun, Earth, early on the 20th, followed by Mars, Venus, Uranus. And it's well possible that following that convergence on the 20th, larger seismic activity will occur. But because we have not had a major earthquake so far, especially with the convergence that we had on the 12th, I'd say be on watch with the planetary conjunctions. Today, tomorrow, they could result in a major earthquake as well, not just the stronger shaking that we usually see. It's a bit difficult to make estimates here because the planetary conjunctions are spread out over 4 days. If it were a tight convergence, we could isolate the next 2-3 days as most critical. That's not the case. So be on watch with these planetary conjunctions. They literally are like electric currents. They generate electric currents, and this impacts our atmosphere and Earth's crust. And where stress is highest, there will be increased seismic activity. Then later in the week, on the 22nd, 23rd, there will be a convergence of critical lunar geometry, especially the right angles with Mars, Jupiter and Uranus. And that will be in an opposite fashion, and that makes things critical. We could easily see major seismic activity following that lunar geometry. And then we have planetary geometry also with the Mercury and Jupiter on the 24th, and also on the 25th, Sun, Mercury and Mars. If a quick look at the solar system, we see almost a quadruple conjunction with Mars, Mercury, Venus and Uranus, but that's not the case. Like I said, we have the planetary conjunctions spread out over 4 days, and we can see, or we're likely to going to see, increased seismic activity with this planetary geometry. We also see Mercury, Sun and Earth in a conjunction. On itself, not necessarily critical, but in combination with the other planetary conjunctions, we can see considerable seismic increase there. Atmospheric fluctuations. We had a really busy atmosphere around the 14th, on the 13th, 14th and 15th, quite some disturbance in the atmosphere actually. And we'll go over this very quickly. We also have them on the website and we share these fluctuations in the social media. On the 12th, we had some fluctuations, not really large, marking regions over South America, the Caribbean plate, and possibly North America. And then on the 13th, also moderate, not really critical from what we could tell. And there were regions marked in the Middle East, to the north, the Carpathian Mountains, Romania. It may not be long for a larger earthquake to occur there. If that happens, it usually occurs pretty deep, around 90 or 100 kilometers deep. It can be felt easily, but usually it doesn't cause much damage. And also further to the south into the Indian Ocean. Then on the 14th, the first fluctuations were not too critical, as we could tell, over South America again, and then the Caribbean plate and North America. And then it really became really strong in the atmosphere, strong disturbance, marking regions over the West Pacific from Japan in the north down to New Zealand. And it continued over several hours. So we marked additional regions near to Taiwan and then Papua New Guinea and also south of New Zealand. And a third was marked over regions, the Hindu Kush region in the north, and then the Himalayan mountains and further south along Sumatra, Java. These are estimates, and we cannot say where the larger seismic activity potentially will occur. These were really critical fluctuations. The last time we had these kind of fluctuations was in May, 4 days before a magnitude 7.7 occurred at the Loyalty Islands. So that tells you something about the potential, what we read in the atmosphere. And then on the 15th, also fluctuations obvious, marking a region specifically near the Azores, also going over West Africa and also south of Africa. There could be a strong to major seismic event there. This could be a significant indicator. Not sure what Europe is going to do, but be on watch. There could be a stronger seismic activity. This could also be over the Atlantic Ridge. The Mid-Atlantic Ridge can produce strong and even major seismic activity. This is what we have so far. Again, we have planetary conjunctions spread out over several days. Unfortunately, be on watch. A clustering of stronger earthquakes is likely to occur, and we may see also a major seismic event with these planetary conjunctions. Unfortunately, I cannot say it will be on this day or on that day, again, because the geometry is too spread out to make such a precise estimate. Be safe, everyone. Until next time.